in this video tutorial, I'm going to talk a little bit about how we can actually look at a fault, a transform fault on the surface of the Earth, and we can understand whether it is a right lateral strike slip fault or a left lateral strike slip fault using something that I call the belly button rule. Now, it has a funny name, so it makes it very easy to understand. And what I'm going to actually draw is your transform or your strike slip fault. Again, we're looking at stuff that's in map view. Okay, so I'm going to use this big black marker to draw in my fault. Okay, now what we want to do is figure out what sense of motion we have for the offset. So we're going to imagine that there's a feature on here. We're going to say a train track. Okay, and this has been offset to over here. And the question is this a right lateral strike slip fault or a left lateral strike slip fault? Now, what we can see, trying to understand the motion, is that in this case, this side has gone in that direction, and that side has gone in that direction. But is it right lateral or left lateral? Might be hard to tell. So what I like to tell people to do is to imagine that you're standing on this train track, and you're going to go walking down the train track until you put your toes on the fault line, or your belly button on the fault line. And then while you're standing there, okay, you have to decide you turn to the left or to the right to go and find the other half of the feature. In this case, when I'm standing here with my belly button on the fault, I have to turn to my right to go down to catch the other side of the train track. Now, if I'm on the other side of the fault, on this side, it does the same thing. If I walk all the way to the fault, put my belly button on it, and then do I look to the left? Nope. I look to the right to go and connect that piece. So this is an example of a right lateral strike slip fault. Oops. Okay. Now, just to kind of go as a quick reminder on the other half, we'll just draw the fault looking the same direction. Now we're going to offset it differently. This time we'll make a river that's going to have gone along the fault. And this time it's actually traveling on the fault. And we can see that the motion is opposite here. Okay, but again, to go over that belly button rule, if we walk along the river, we have to look to the left to see the other side. Or if we come from this direction, we're always going to be looking to our left. So this is our left lateral strike slip fault. Okay, so again, it's just a sense of, you know, if you're walking down it, you put your belly button on the fault, if you turn left or to the right to meet up with the other side of the feature, be it a road, a river, or a rock band that's been offset. And so that's how you can determine if something is a right lateral or left lateral strike slip fault from using an aerial photograph, topographic map, or silly diagram.